If I may, my name is Heather Deck. I am the river keeper with the Family Guitar River Foundation, and have been doing a lot of work on this since we saw the public comment come out, the public notice come out December 1, I believe it was. I think maybe I might be able to answer some of the questions. It would take me a lot longer than you all want to listen to, I think, at this point in time. So I'm available for anyone to talk tonight or later on in the week at the office. A couple things. The Martin Marietta has secured a mining permit. They actually secured that back in 2010, and they did a modified permit this year in 2011. This mine actually has been in the works for, I think, the documents I saw back, even as far back as 2004. We ourselves at the office were really not aware of it, except for a rumor that came out around mid-November, and then we saw the public comment December 1st. The one thing about the Corps of Engineers that we found out when we had asked to go see the file with the application that Martin Marietta has submitted, they have a new policy at the Corps office which requires a Freedom of Information Act request to get that document. So we did go through that process, and we do have the application and all the information that Martin Marietta had submitted to the Corps of Engineers and the Division of Water Quality. The Division of Water Quality is a state agency that does not require Freedom of Information Act, so I was able to get basically that application sent to me from them. Jim Simon, that you had talked about, he is the Director of Division of Land Resources, but that is the agency that has already given their permit. So that permit has already been approved. The permit that we're working under, the comment period that we're working under right now, is what's called a 401 or a 404 permit. 401 is a state permit, the 404 is. The company will also have to secure a wastewater discharge permit. They have applied for that. The Division of Water Quality at the state level is actively processing that permit. There will be then another comment period for the public to be able to have an opportunity to comment, and that is regarding the 9 million gallons per day wastewater discharge. And that probably comment period, most likely the estimated date will be the end of this month. It will be another 30-day period then to comment there. The Director of Division of Water Quality has the authority to hold a public hearing on an issue about a permit. This will be a major wastewater discharge permit in that category. And so I think if everyone in this room and others that are out there were to comment to the Division of Water Quality that we want a public hearing, it would be very hard for them to say no. They don't do them very often because they're expensive and it takes resources, but they do them when there's issues like a ride like this, when a lot of questions have not been answered. The concern that our foundation has, obviously, is for Blunt's Creek. First, the 9 million gallons a day discharge will be from the open pit mine. They won't be sinking a well. They'll actually be pumping it out of the open pit. What they're planning on doing is having all of the storm water from the mine site, so where they have their buildings and where they have trucks and other things, actually all flow into the mine pit. They will then put their mine water, the open pit mine water, into some clarifying ponds, some settling ponds, and out into a ditch network and into two upper tributaries of Blunt's Creek. And so that is what they propose to do. The second problem and concern that we have, same with you, is that it's not been a very transparent process. And so that's the conversation that we've had with the governor's office, too, that it needs to be a transparent process. The second issue that you guys have already all touched on is the drawdown of the Castlehaine aquifer. There have been identified in a study close to 200 landowners and families within a 6 to 7 mile area of the mine site that will see drawdowns exceeding 5 feet in their wells. And the Beaufort County well sites are outside of that line, but that doesn't mean that they may not be impacted. The town of Vanceboro also has wells very near to that line. So that is also a concern of ours. So, again, just some information, and I'll stop there, but I'm happy to be a resource for anyone.
Heather, do you have any phone numbers or email addresses we can get from you?
Yes, and if folks would go to our website, we're working diligently to get that on. We have a new website that takes us a little while to get information up. We also have generated an email with information that has gotten out, I think, to some of you, so if you would just give me your email address, we can get you that.
Heather, what's your email?
Heather, one question. Do you have any idea how far that mine's going to be from the prison down there in Craven County?
I do not. And I have the car.
Divorced Donovan, I live in Bay Harbor, Alaska. I used to work for, in another state for environmental control, and I know how slow the Corps of Engineers can be, but if I remember correctly, and I've been out of it for quite a while, the Corps of Engineers doesn't have to do an ecological survey if they don't want to. So the more we speak up, the more pressure we put on them to do that study. They are under no obligation. They can make the decision whether or not to do that study. So as many people that can get out, sign petitions, get to the meetings, anything to do with the Corps, plus they always got to get paid. It takes them 2 or 3 years to get started. But we want to get to them since they do a study and it's on their agenda to do it.
Anybody? Again, I urge you to call your county office at 946-0079. And if you want to speak, tell me you want to speak, as the gentleman says. If you don't, they are no obligation to listen to you.
You won't get on the agenda proper, but you can get asked to be on public speaking.
They'll have a public comment.
And we need this done because we want them to know we want to overwhelm them. We want them to know, you know, that we're serious on this. And if we wait to the last day, you won't get on.
They'll have a public comment because, again, they have no obligation to listen to you. Next Monday night at 5:00. On 3rd Street, county office.
But if they know there's going to be this big crowd, they may want to maybe even have it somewhere else. Because that really won't
come to the center. Okay, does anybody have anything else that we want to make a comment before we adjourn? Yeah, I'm just sorry you came. I mean, this, we didn't have these public hearings, but at least we gave you a chance to.
Has everybody signed it?
No.
You know, this is what we need, Mayor. We need it to be able to, you know, throw this out.
I found out this afternoon.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, everybody.